I'm Dennis Hofford, the program coordinator for the Eau Claire Area Improvements Program. So we have 9 projects in the program, 3 major infrastructure projects: Eau Claire Plaza redevelopment, the Jaipur Bridge replacement, or Eau Claire Flood Barrier and Promenade, and then multiple small projects within that: replacement of the Center Street ramps, the 3rd Ave cycle track detour, the Eau Claire neighborhood hub, and many other projects. The program was a continuation of West Eau Claire Park, which was the first section completed of the downtown flood barrier, and has continued through the design phases and up to construction, which started in 2021, and full completion of the area, all the projects, by 2023. The projects in Eau Claire are really about creating public spaces and integrating them with civil infrastructure. So we recognize the downtown as a major economic driver for the city. It's at risk for a flood from the river, from a high water event. And so protecting that investment is really a top priority for the city. And so providing that resiliency within a public space that can also be beautiful, attractive, a place for people to gather, to reflect and explore, is kind of one of our main goals and themes. And so it's really about how, as an organization, we can take multiple business units, integrate several projects, and provides an enhanced experience along the waterfront. We have this beautiful amenity, the Bow River, and it's really providing access to the river and being able to enjoy that as a place to gather, connect, reflect, and explore. Green Line Station is a really important connection for the neighborhood of Eau Claire, as it will provide access for people living outside of the downtown. So it's really about providing those transportation options, but also having that mass transit just really ensures that the space is able to be enjoyed by everybody. There has been a lot of coordination between the Green Line project and the Eau Claire projects, and we understand that there will be disruptions to the future Eau Claire pathways, but it's been planned in such a way that designs will be incorporated to be as seamless as we've experienced with the first round of projects.